This Women's Month, ANC puts the spotlight on remarkable women in Philippine society. Market Edge talked to Stephanie Kubota of Rush Technologies, who is among the lady bosses under the wing of Globe's telecom startup builder 917 Ventures. The company is helping MSMEs in the food and beverage sector grow their business while paving the way for their digitalization. Kubota says more needs to be done to increase women representation in the tech field.
As much as we can contribute during the workforce recruitment, career development area, it really starts at the beginning, right? Introducing STEM into education and representing, because women are very underrepresented within the tech space. It's really representing these women at the beginning of their education and showing them that there is a career path inside technology. And similarly, when they are recruited, when women go through the phases of their life, it's providing that work-life balance based on the priorities of their life. So, for example, in Rush, we have a hybrid working environment where our female homemakers are able to spend time with their families as well as prioritize their work at the same time. So I really think it's just saying women can have it all. It's not easy, but it's possible.
Jeff Bezos has reclaimed the title of the richest person on earth. Bezos dethroned Elon Musk in the Bloomberg Billionaires Index. The Amazon founder's net worth is at $200 billion after gaining $23 billion over the past year. The Tesla founder, on the other hand, has a net worth of $198 billion. Musk has lost about $31 billion over the past year. A major victory for Donald Trump as he seeks to regain the U.S. presidency. The U.S. Supreme Court unanimously reversed a Colorado court decision to kick Trump off the state's Republican primary ballot, citing the Constitution's 14th Amendment. The Colorado court earlier ruled Trump should be barred from holding public office again after taking part in an insurrection for inciting the January 2021 Capitol attack. But the U.S. Supreme Court says only Congress can enforce that constitutional provision. The ruling was issued on the eve of Super Tuesday, the day in the U.S. presidential primary cycle when most states hold nominating contests. France enshrines the right to abortion in its constitution, becoming the first in the world to do so. Lawmakers overwhelmingly backed the move 780 to 72 in a special joint vote of the two houses of parliament. President Emmanuel Macron described the move as French pride that had sent a universal message. Women's rights activists gathered in central Paris to celebrate the historic decision. Experts from the United Nations say there are reasonable grounds to believe sexual violence occurred during this October 7 attack on Israel by Hamas militants. The team, led by the UN Special Envoy for Sexual Violence, visited Israel on a mission to verify information on the alleged assaults. It says a full-fledged investigation would be required to establish the overall magnitude of the sexual violence, which Hamas has repeatedly denied.
We found clear and convincing information that sexual violence, including rape, sexualized torture, cruel, inhuman, and degrading treatment, has been committed against captives. And we also have reasonable grounds to believe that such violence may still be ongoing against those still held in captivity. I pause and must add that I am of the strong opinion that this finding does not in any way legitimize further violence, but actually reinforces the need for an urgent ceasefire.
Hamas fighters attacked Israel last October 7, killing around 1,200 and seizing 253 hostages. Israel's retaliation has since killed around 30,000 Palestinians in the Gaza Strip. Israel claims the UN aid agency in Gaza employed over 450 military operatives from Hamas and other militant groups. The Israeli military has presented voice recordings as proof of UNRWA employees allegedly discussing their actions during the attack, including entering Israel and kidnapping women.
Over 450 UNRWA employees are military operatives in terror groups in Gaza. Over 450. This is no mere coincidence. This is systematic. There is no claiming we did not know. Hamas exploits humanitarian organizations and uses them to commit crimes against humanity. These terrorists are employed by UNRWA. They receive salaries that are paid for by the international community. Donations that are meant for humanitarian purposes, meant to benefit the people of Gaza, are funding mass murderers and rapists. We sent the information that I'm sharing now, as well as further intelligence, to our international partners, including the UN.
Earlier allegations by Israel that UNRWA employees doubled as Hamas members and participated in the October 7 attack prompted the U.S. and other countries to pause funding to the agency.